So my question to you is, if I was your son, what would your advice be if I was to get pulled over by a police officer?
Oh, Jamar. You know, can I start by saying you remind me again about white privilege? You remind me, I have two kids, a son and a daughter, who are grown now, long time. I had to have a lot of talks with my kids, but I never had to have one about what to do if you get pulled over by the police because the risks are greater for you because of the color of your skin. And I'm sorry that that's the talk that you're asking about. I think the way the talk starts is by saying, this is not your fault. This is a fault of discrimination, and that we still feel it in this world. And here's one of the tangible effects that comes out. And I think we say, I say, you got to know your rights. You got to know how to protect yourself. You got to know about what you don't volunteer, what you don't let people do. I want to make sure you always know your rights. And then the third part to the conversation with my child would be, help me change this. Help us make a better criminal justice system, but more importantly, help us make a better America where this is no longer an issue and you don't have to have this talk with your children and your children don't have to have this talk with their children and so on into the future. Come on, let us begin to end the need for this conversation.
If I were your daughter, what advice would you give me the next time I am stopped by the police?
If you were my daughter, you'd be a Caucasian girl and you wouldn't be pulled over. That's what's wrong. That is what's wrong. There is institutional racism that still exists. And what it should require is every police department in America should have to go through what they used to call back when I first got started in the women's movement, sensitivity training. For example, I require